Hello and welcome to Finance Walk. In this video, we'll cover annual reports analysis part 2. In last video, we covered balance sheet and income statement analysis. And in this video, we primarily will cover cash flow analysis and how to read footnotes. Okay, so we'll see what we are going to cover in this video. In this chapter, we'll cover cash flow analysis and footnotes, how to read footnotes. Okay, cash flow analysis. What is meaning of cash flow analysis? Cash flow and cash flow statement is a financial statement that shows a company's incoming and outgoing money during a time period. The statement shows how changes in balance sheet and income accounts affected cash and cash equivalents, and breaks the analysis down according to operating, investing, and financing activities. As an analytical tool, the statement of cash flows is useful in determining the short-term viability of a company, particularly its ability to pay bills. There are three activities primarily: operating activities, financing activities, and investing activities. Operating activities include the production, sales, and delivery of the company's product, as well as collecting payment from its customers. This could include purchasing raw materials, building inventory, advertising, and shipping the product. The amount of cash flows arising from operating activities is a key indicator of the extent to which the operations of the enterprise have generated sufficient cash flows to maintain the operating capability of the enterprise, pay dividends, repay loans, and make new investments without recourse to external sources of financing. So this cash flow, operating cash flow, is a key indicator, especially to check operating capability of the enterprise, pay dividends, repay loans, and make new investments. Okay. Cash flows from operating activities are primarily derived from the principal revenue producing activities of the enterprise. I repeat, cash flows from operating activities are primarily derived from the principal revenue producing activities of the enterprise. Therefore, they generally result from the transactions and other events that enter into the determination of net profit or loss. Let's see example of operating cash flows. Receipts from the sale of goods or services, receipts for the sale of loans, debt or equity instruments in a trading portfolio, interest received on loans, dividends received on equity securities, payments to suppliers for goods and services, payments to employees or on behalf of employees, tax payments, interest payments. Alternatively, this can be reported under financing activities in IAS 7 but not in US GAAP. Payments for the sale of loans, debt or equity instruments in a trading portfolio. Items which are added back to the net income figure, that is, which is found on the income statement, to arrive at cash flows from operations generally include depreciation, deferred tax, amortization. Any gains or losses associated with an asset sale, that is, unrealized gains, losses, are also added back from the income statement. After operating activities, let's see what are investing activities. Investing activities include the cash flows that represent the extent to which expenditures have been made for resources intended to generate future income and cash flows. I repeat, investing activities include the cash flows that represent the extent to which expenditure have been made for resources intended to generate future income and cash flows. Let's see examples of investing cash flows. So examples of cash flows arising from investing activities are, first, collections on loan principal and the sales of other firm's debt instruments, investment returns from other firm's equity instruments, including sale of those instruments, receipts from sale of plant and equipment. Fourth is expenditure for purchase of plant and equipment. Fifth is loans made and acquisition of other firm's debt instruments. And lastly, expenditure for purchase of other firm's equity instruments. So these are the activities which are included in investing cash flows. Okay, now let's see which are the items under investing activities. So items under investing activities include capital expenditures, which include purchases and sales of property, plant and equipment, and secondly investments. Okay, now after covering operating activities and investing activities, let's go to financing activities. So financing activities include the inflow of cash from investors such as banks and shareholders, debenture holders, as well as outflow of cash to shareholders as dividends as the company generates income. Other activities which impact the long-term liabilities and equity of the company are also listed in the financing activities section of the cash flow statement. Okay, now examples of cash flows. Okay, we have checked examples of now we'll see what items are included in financing cash flows. So financing cash flows include proceeds from issuing shares, proceeds from issuing short-term or long-term debt, payments of dividends, payments for repurchase of company shares, and repayment of debt principal, including capital leases. So this is about cash flow analysis.